time by more, you know, new stuff. And I remember this particular one. Ms. Collins made the comment the last board meeting she attended, and she sought me out. And she said, "Jack, we've not always seen eye to eye, but you and I pretty much vote together when it's an issue that involves what's best for students and so forth." And I think that points to the spirit of this board and the things that we discuss, the issues that we face in the last few years. The system, if everyone is more concerned about their own backyard than the whole system, the system falls apart. Somewhere along the way, everyone has to look at what's best for 10,000 students as opposed to what's best for 1,000. And as long as the board does that, we'll make the right decision for Sullivan County schools. I'm proud to be a member of this board because we've consistently done that. Everybody doesn't have to vote, you know, same. We understand everybody has particular reasons for voting the way they do, and I don't think I've ever really criticized anyone for the way they voted on an issue. That's a very personal question. But the board has to do what's right for the majority of the students. And as a rule, we have done that year in and year out, and I'm just proud to be a part of this organization and to have served with you for 24 years. And it is a little bittersweet, but I'm ready to move on. And someone asked, "Well, why don't you run again?" I said, "Well, if I run again, I'll be almost 80. And my grandchildren are here. My oldest one is 6. I've got 2 more out in Arizona. And, you know, it's a beautiful time to go visit out there in January and February. That's what I plan to do. My wife would have been here tonight. I was going to get her to tell the tale. She told me about resigning from the board. But she's out there looking after grandchildren tonight.